Good morning, everybody, and welcome to another fresh new week. It's time for your another fantastic Monday, September 27th, episode 490, just 10 more days, and we'll hit the big 500. Today, we're still in the mini-series, because yesterday we had the video number 30. Today we got number 31. And then tomorrow, I'm just going to give you a full warning, tomorrow's will be the same with number 32. So we're having three back-to-back days of the series. That's weird. These the series and it's all about God series are popping up left and right. But hey, we're 31 since I started this little series. But today we're going to be talking about the new creation. Man, hair keep getting messed up. Sorry about that. But I just before I started recording this, I tried it. Something went wrong with my camera. And I was like, dang it. So I had to shut down the camera, turn it back on, and here we go. We're recording. So I don't know if something went wrong, but I don't know. I fixed it, whatever it was. I hate when it does that. Either something like that, that's the first time that's ever happened. But other times, it comes up saying I've got to clear space to record more videos. Because somehow or another, this computer, its video size takes up a lot of space when you're saving them into the computer to hold them until you can get them moved over to your flash drive. And then I put them over there to hold them until so long, then I get rid of some of the older ones to make room for the newer ones that I have to get rid of off the computer. Because I let it go for a little bit and then it, but I just hope it don't do that when I'm recording one there. Bam! I don't have the thing done before it runs out of space. But the new creation, we're going to be starting with Galatians chapter 6, verse 15. So if you're excited about this new fresh week, finishing up the month of September, and then starting a new month, the new month of October, with the fall season just starting. And prior to recording this video, I just checked on the football game, the Florida Gator football game. And Florida Gators just got another touchdown. Yeah, touchdown. And at that moment, it was 24-14 as of recording this. So yay, Gators. Go. And maybe you'll find out probably tomorrow. Tomorrow's video, who won? If you don't already know, so. But if you're excited about this new week, to finish up the 1 month and start a whole new month, and if you're excited about episode 500 coming for me, smash the like button, drop a comment about it, and if you haven't watched any of my older videos, go back and watch some. There's some pretty good ones in there. I've had a playlist that's meant for the whole 10 days that I did the Ten Commandments from this book, from one of these books. Each day we went through over one of the Ten Commandments, and I put them all on a playlist. So if you want to listen to the story about the Ten Commandments, go watch that. If you want to listen to the study of Colossians, go watch that playlist. But go back and watch some of these older videos, and you'll get a joy out of some of them. You'll hear some good stories. But if you're new here, subscribe, click that notification bell, share the video and the channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that goal of 1,000 subscribers. Which will make me an official. It'll officially start funding my videos will start getting funded for all the views, the likes, the dislikes, and the It won't do nothing about the thing, but it's just the views, the likes, the dislikes, the sharing will help out everything. So just help me get that, help me reach that goal, and I will appreciate you like no other. So, without further ado, let's get into the new creation. Galatians 6:15 says, "For in Christ Jesus neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creation." So in the original Greek text of the New Testament, the word translated creature is the same as creation. So Paul, in our beginning verse, is stressing the vital importance of being a new creation in Christ. And the Lord Jesus Christ is nothing less than the mighty creator of the heaven and the earth. Colossians 1:16. And speaking of Colossians, there's one of your verses of Colossians. Go back and watch that study of Colossians. There's 33 videos. It was only like 30 days, but there's 33 videos because of, I think I had one day where I had messed up on one part of the video and went and added a second video. Or there was only 30, it was actually only 30 days, but, wait a minute, no, I think it, that was last year, the month of October. There was 30, yeah, there was 30 lessons, but there's 33 videos because of multiple, there was three parts, and another one there was two parts. So there was like one story there, and then the other one was one story, and then I think there was another one that had an extra video to go with it, and the rest of them was all. But go back and watch that one. You'll get it. You'll get three out of it. Speaking of that one, just real quick, I got a comment from a fella some of y'all may know. He's a rapper turned actor, Ice Cube. Yeah, Ice Cube. From Friday, Boys in the Hood. He was a rapper before he became an actor. Barbershop. If you remember Barbershop 1 and 2. Barbershop back in the, they released a third edition of it. XXX State of the Union. And he was also in XXX Return of Xander Cage, because he came in at the end to help out. But he's a pretty good actor. But he popped in on my thing saying, acting like my study was something to do with Colosseums, the buildings. This is a study of Colossians, not Colosseums. This was the book of Colossians that we went through in that series, in that 1 month. So, but I just thought it was just weird that he come back at me with a comment like that, and it's like, what are you talking about, boy? He's a good guy. Don't get me wrong. But I just thought you might want to know about that one. But so we said Colossians 1:16, and the very same creative power that called the universe into existence must be exerted on each lost sinner to create in him a new nature, capable of having an eternal fellowship with God, for man and woman was created in the beginning. So this new creation is not only for the purpose of saving their souls, but also for transforming their lives. And in 2 Corinthians 5:17, it says, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new." Oh, we're going to go over 10 minutes today on this one. Although good works can never bring salvation, salvation must inevitably bring good works. For we are thereby created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them. Ephesians 2:10. And Paul exhorts us to continually put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Ephesians 4:24. Even Adam and Eve were originally created in the image of God, Genesis 1:27. But that image had been grievously damaged by unbelief and overt sin. So although still resident in man, in fact, distinguish him from the animals, this divine image must be renewed through saving faith in our Creator, Redeemer, Jesus Christ. Amen? And therefore the Scripture reminds all true believers that they, Colossians 3:9-10, have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. Amen? So, that's all I have for that one. Coming up later tonight, in your Monday Turning Point Devo, after 7 this evening, we're going to be talking about sea change. That's what it's. And it'll be episode 50. If I'm not mistaken, I think it's episode 50. So we got episode 490. And then we'll go back episode 50. We're hitting 50. We're almost to 2 months. We're almost to 2 months into this one. But we're going to be starting off with 1 Corinthians 2:12. Recommended reading, 1 Corinthians 2:6-16. Minus the first 5 verses, and then you read 6 to the rest of the chapter. And you'll also read verse 12 within that one. So we'll read the recommended reading and then compare it to what they got on the page here. It might be the same verse. It might be put the same way, but we can compare it. It's not no different version. It's just, your turning point is from Clara H. Scott. And I guess it's from the Open My Eyes That I May See. I don't know whether it's a song, a poem, or something along that line. But your daily reading of the Bible reading for the day is Haggai 1 and 2, which that'd be the whole chapter. And then starting tomorrow, you start Zechariah for 3 days. Then you go to Malachi on Friday for 1 day. And then you jumped to the New Testament, because Malachi would be the last one of the Old Testament. Then you jump to the New Testament on Saturday and Sunday, for that first weekend of October. So, stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But I know this video and yesterday's videos are a day apart. I recorded those two videos on Friday, and here it is Saturday evening, and I've got these, and I'm starting these. This evening's video. And I think I'm going to go ahead and do two for Tuesday. So, two for tomorrow. So, but I had the same shirt, because I just happened to come home from shopping and dinner and everything. Put back on my comfortable shirt so I can at least do today's videos and tomorrow's. I usually try to do three, maybe 4 days. Depends on the days, all in the same shirt, so I can have a package deal. So I may not get the videos up until the day before. They'll be already loaded, but all I got to do is go in there, fix the description, do the recording when it was when it was recorded, and when it was, and then fix the ending part up, and then set it up for what day it's supposed to come, set it up for the next day, whatever time it's supposed to come out. So, but sorry for rambling about that, but I love you, I appreciate it, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it, stay tuned for that later this evening for your Monday Turning Point later tonight. But keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until tomorrow, or until later, sorry, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your fantastic Monday. And tune in after 7 tonight for your Monday Turning Point and Sea Change. Can't wait to see what that one's going to all be about. I'll get that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that tonight. So, but until then, goodbye.